Thank you.
He's a freshman at Michigan State and is doing great. And he's building a team. Just to give you a recap, he's building a team out there and doing great with that. But as you probably know, with what you do every day, you know, there's different conversations that have to happen, and we're trying to figure out how to grab more attention to his audience. You know, he's talking to a lot of people, but not really sure about, you know, other things he could be doing to get them engaged and how to move this conversation. So that's really where we are.
Awesome. Well, Caleb, why don't you just share with me kind of what you're doing now, kind of just a little bit of background on kind of your Isagenix journey so far, just so I have kind of a grasp and then I can try to offer any help I can.
Yeah. So, I think it all really started after Celebration. I went in Vegas this year and all this went on and everything afterwards, and I felt the grind. And so I think I've been doing a pretty good job. You know, when I first got to school, having a lot of conversations with the people I was meeting, and a lot of people seemed to be interested in it. The only issue is with college students is either they don't have any motivation, they don't understand that this is a business that you have to take seriously. This isn't a get rich quick. This isn't a, you know, you can, you know, do this for a half hour and be done for the day.
Right.
Which is hard for a lot of kids because, you know, there are other temptations and stuff like that. So it's all about finding the right people there. Also, a lot of college kids are broke too, which makes, you know, the objective of, you know, the price of these products a challenge. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, that's kind of my main audience are people. The biggest objections I get are that, you know, they're too busy either with work or or they don't have enough money. So
right.
that's as far as school, you know, kids at school, that's how that's been going.
Yeah, for sure. So have you been able to identify anybody that like is really excited about it and like kind of starting to run with you? Or, I mean,
yeah, the only one who really sees the vision is my roommate who I've gotten into this, and I guess that's just from him being around me so much.
That's good. So, no, that's great.
That's it, yeah. So we were able to, I guess, put together a good number of people, but, you know, over the past couple of months, they've seemed to drop off. So I'm at that point where it's like I got to kind of start over again.
Uh-huh. So what is it that you're looking to really create through Isagenix? I mean, what, like at Celebration, what got you so excited? And I mean, where do you see yourself in the next, you know, 3 to 5 years?
In the next 3 to 5 years, I see myself, you know, at least 6 figures in this. I think that's pretty attainable.
What do you want to do with that income? I mean, what's kind of the driver, you know, behind that?
Yeah, so what really turned me on at Celebration about this was the fact that, you know, I could share this with other people my age, and then we can all start working at this and create, you know, a financially free future for ourselves. And what most people don't realize and what's hard to, you know, kind of put into their mind is what this can actually create. And that's something that you can only, you know, figure out and learn at Celebration and, you know, NYKO, I'm very excited for. Because there's nothing like that. If they're only going to know as much as I know,
right?
You know, when I'm describing this, so they might not totally get the full vision of what this can do and how we can help people. But I don't know. I certainly do. So,
is your roommate coming into your kickoff?
No, he's not. But he's coming to Celebration.
Oh, good. Well, that's huge. Yep. So I'm telling. I mean, you're hitting it on the head. I mean, one of the things that young people just resonates so much with is our culture and events. I mean, it happened for you. I mean, if all you did from now until Celebration in Nashville was just like, I'm just going to get as many people as I can, you know, young people as I can to that event. And, you know, why not set a goal at 10 people? I mean, if that happened, I mean, all of those 10 people, I mean, the lights are going to flick on just like they flicked on for you. And that's the quickest way for somebody to grasp the vision. Cause you're right. I mean, it's, you know, it's, you know, people can get excited about, you know, start getting excited about the product and, you know, everything that you're telling them, but it's kind of the social proof of the event that flicks everybody's lights on. And, you know, it happened for you, obviously.
Right.
So that's huge. You know, I would say that, it sounds like, you know, you're doing everything right. I mean, you're, you know, you've got a powerful vision of what you want to create. You know, you want to earn six figures. You know, do you have a time frame on that?
Six figures I wanted to do by Celebration this year.
Celebration. Good. That's great.
Hard goal, but, you know, set them high. So even if it does happen, I'll still be very satisfied. But that's what the goal is.
Good. Well, I mean, in order to do that, I mean, that's awesome. And it's a big goal. In order to do that, obviously it's going to take, you know, a lot of consistent, persistent action and just talking to a ton of people. Right. And so, how much time now do you think you're dedicating towards building?
Now, not as much as I did, just because, I kind of needed some quick cash. I've been doing, you know, some other things while trying to grow, you know, this lasting business. But so yeah, right now not as much as I have been.
Okay. And are you doing like any sort of like a, like, so for me, at like when I was in college, I went to Arizona State. We did like weekly kind of like presentations in the apartment complex that I lived in. And they had like a conference room that you could rent out. And literally the entire week, it was just all about getting as many young people as I could to that meeting. It was on Tuesday nights. And, you know, we just get in there, we talk a little bit about the products, what we're doing for young people. And so that's one thing that I would say, because young people resonate with, again, they got to see that other young people are going to kind of want it, are doing this also, and they thrive off of community. I mean, that's what young people thrive off of. And so, if you're not doing it, I would encourage you to, you know, start doing like a weekly, or even a bi-monthly, you do it once every 2 weeks to start out with that. And, you know, you and your roommate can just set an intention like, hey, our goal is to get five new people each at this, event on Tuesday night. And that's how this thing starts. Literally, that's how it starts. And then you start building a little community of people who either want to run with you or don't, but that's okay. And so, but I would, and the reason why I asked you about, you know, what kind of your vision is, and you want to figure out what's the vision that you want to kind of cast at these events and when you're talking with other people. And it, you know, like for me, it sounded something like, when I was out talking to people, or when I was out calling people, it was like, you know, hey, so-and-so, I've recently found something that is changing my entire life. It's changing my health. It's changing like my financial blueprint, the way I think about things. And I'm looking for young, motivated people that are looking to create a six-figure income by the time they graduate by helping tons of people. And we do this thing every Tuesday night. It may or may not be for you, but would you be open to come checking this out? And that worked for me. And so, I mean, you have to kind of figure out what's going to kind of work for you. But what I would say is young people are want to attach to a vision. And so it's kind of like if you're throwing it out there that, hey, you know, I'm looking for young, motivated people that are looking to create a six-figure income in the next, you know, by the time they graduate school and get healthy at the same time, you know, there's going to be people that get excited. I mean, if you're casting that vision over and over and over, eventually it's going to land on good people that want to run with you, like your roommate, which is awesome. I mean, he's probably picking up on your infectious energy and your conviction and everything you want to do. And so, I would just team up with your roommate and say, hey, let's do these things, you know, whatever, every Tuesday night or every other Tuesday night, you know, whether you do them at like, are you in a dorm now?
Yeah.
Yep. Okay.
Every Wednesday night, we would do something like that, like an opportunity meeting. And we usually do it so like when it would end, the free enrollment code or free shipping code would be released from the Wednesday night Zoom calls, Lisa doing Zoom calls.
Oh yeah.
So it's incentive obviously to sign up then. But what are some of the ways you would spread the word or market those meetings? Because I know not a ton of people should, you know, usually show up, but what are some
The in-person meetings, like the in-person opportunity meetings?
Like the, no, like a public every weekly type thing.
Right. But are you talking about the Zoom calls or the, something that you would do?
Yeah.
Something you would do? Yeah, in person. Yeah. So, I mean, honestly, it's just about talking to people. I mean, you can try to put things out on social media as far as like, you know, invitations and stuff like that. But, I believe it's about, you know, just getting in front of people and saying, hey, you know, what are you doing on Wednesday night? Great. Well, we've got something that I think that you may or may not love, but it's something I'm so pumped about. And you just, you know, you and your roommate are just calling people, texting people, getting them to show up at this event. But I would have them, watch like some sort of something, like listen to a recorded call or watch the start video or something like that before they're just showing up to the event, because you want to get these people like just showing up and they're like, okay, what the heck is this thing? You want to, you know, at least get them exposed to Isagenics and what you're doing, you know, one or two times before you're getting them to this event.
Right.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
So it may take like you meet somebody for coffee, you meet somebody for lunch or whatever, you start telling them about Isagenic, what you're doing, and then you invite them to the event. So at least they know what they're coming to.
Right.
Because that's kind of, it's awkward when, you know, they show up and they're like, okay, what the heck is this thing?
Yeah. That sounds very familiar. they would just come and just be like, what is this? What am I listening to? And then just stand there very awkwardly or sit there very awkwardly when I, you know, ask opening questions or something. as if money doesn't pertain to them.
Yeah, exactly.
Erik, I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Is there, so I know with the Start group and the younger Start group, is there a different presentation that you'd recommend versus one that, you know, maybe that we're doing? Do you use, you know, the typical videos, or is there like a kind of a specific target with here's a different vision for the younger group that you're using at these opportunity meetings?
Yeah. So on startyourlife.com, there's a presentation that you can download. It's the most current Start presentation that we use at the Vision Tour. I think it's like 25 slides or something like that, but it talks about, you know, Start and like, you know, the vision of Start and everything like that. And then it goes into the products and the opportunity and stuff like that. So it's catered a little bit more young for sure. And that's why we have it. And there's a lot of people using that. Have you seen that presentation?
I don't know. I haven't.
Okay. So yeah, if you go on startyourlife.com.
Yeah.
Let me just look here. It should be, under tools. And then you can download. It's the latest one we use at the Vision Tour. In 2017, I'm just going to do it now. Tools. Yeah, so it says tools and resources, and then you scroll down, download the 2017 Start Vision Tour presentation.
Awesome.
It'll be right there. And again, typically, you know, you could play the Start video to kick off those meetings. Like I think a great one is the original one we have, it's still on Start. It's,
I really like the Profession for the Next Generation video too.
Oh, good. Yeah, awesome. Yeah, I mean, yeah, either one.
Yeah.
Kind of play that. And then again, I mean, these things don't have to be complicated. You don't even have to use the presentation if you don't want to. Literally, you could get up, play the video, thank everybody for coming. Just share your personal story about what you've been doing and what you're excited about. You know, lay out some of the products, talk about the product, you know, get your roommate up there sharing his story. And that's it. And like, you know, cut up some of the products and have people try and socialize, you know, make them fun. Like, you don't want to make them, you know, these stiff meetings. I mean, have music going, because so much of the decision-making process and the attractiveness of it is just kind of the hanging out before and after the meeting, and, you know, just making these things fun. It's not as much about like how great the presentation is.
Right. I got you.
Cool.
Any other questions at all? Or again, it sounds like you're doing a lot of the right things. The thing you got going for you is you got the enthusiasm, you caught the vision, and now it's just about going out and sharing that vision with just consistent passion with everybody you know. I mean, there's no secret to this. And eventually, I mean, some people are going to get excited about it. Some people aren't. Some people are going to say they're going to do this, and then they're gone. But then, you know, a couple months later, they're excited about it because they're in a point in their life where they want to do it. So, you know, but again, it's just about finding those, you know, 2, 3, 4 people that really want to run with you. And you already got one of them in your roommate, which is great. Right.
Yep.
Erik, are there different price objections that you would use for someone younger than, you know, you use, you know, an older prospect, if you will? Is there something different that resonates with these college students?
Well, I mean, one thing that they're already used to doing is spending time or spending money on food. I mean, and especially with, you know, college students, you know, they say they don't have the money, but then they'll go spend, you know, $150 at the bar on, you know, Friday night.
Yeah.
So sometimes it's about calling them out about that and really breaking it down and saying, hey, this is, I mean, how much do you spend every single day on food? And many times it's 10, 15, 20 bucks. And if all you can get them on is like 4 cans of shake, that's great, especially for college students. I mean, if you just get somebody on the shakes, like, yes, it's great to get people on the value packs and the, you know, 30-day system, but sometimes college students can't make that happen. So if it's just about getting them, you know, qualified and getting them on just 4 shakes, then that's great too. But I think that because many of them can't afford it, that's what more reason why you should talk about the income and the money you can make. I understand that you can't afford this right now, but would you be open to a way where I could literally show you within, you know, 2 weeks to a month where you could start, where you could not only afford this, but you could start getting all your products paid for? Step them right into the money and step them into the business opportunity. That's, you know.
Right.
Do you see there's a value in Caleb sharing, you know, our success story, where, you know, a lot of kids will run this by their parents before they jump into it. And, you know, if they have that backup of, you know, Caleb's doing this because he watched us succeed in it, and if he shares,
100%.
They'll be able to say, well, you know, this is Caleb's parents do this, and if you want to talk to them, absolutely, they'll get on the phone with you and share how legit this business is.
Yeah, absolutely, 100%, absolutely. And I think that you could kind of angle that as, you know, we've got some incredible mentors in this company who are all about empowering young people and watching and having them create just such an incredible future for themselves. And two of them happen to be my parents who've been so successful in this, and yeah, getting them on the phone with you guys, and absolutely, all the more you can let people know that this is a family business, you know, the better. I mean, I think that's just incredible. That's what I did in school. I mean, I would, you know, I was talking about how my parents just started this company and everything. So, and my mom would actually come in and sometimes help with some of those presentations. So I know that, you know, I was here locally, so it was a little easier for her to do that. But, you know, if you want to, like, you could Skype into some of the meetings and doing all that stuff too. So it's just so easy with technology these days.
Yeah. When we were moving Caleb into school, he brought 8 guys to a hotel room and we enrolled them. We did a presentation right then and there, and he knows I'll be back out there. He put some people in a room, and we'll do it. We can do it with Skype, and we can do it, you know, in person too. So
I mean, that's awesome. Yeah, you got to leverage that. That's great.
Yeah, awesome. Listen, Eric.
Good. Well,
appreciate your time. Huge. We know how busy you are. You know, you don't have a lot of time in your hands, especially with the new baby. So, how's PETA and Soul doing?
They're doing great. Yeah, it's just crazy how fast everything goes. Like, you know, she's just starting to almost crawl. Like, she's on her knees now, and she's like starting to move her. It's just like any day now she's gonna be crawling. So
it's great.
Watch out.
Precious moments. They didn't stop.
I know exactly. I know.
It's
fun journey.
Go ahead. Sorry.
I was just, Caleb, let me know what I can do. And again, I like, if you get some people in the room too, I would love to help out and, you know, Skype into one of your meetings too, you know, just to help out any way I can. So,
okay. Yeah. Thank you. Definitely.
Awesome. Eric, thank you so much, friend. Thank you very much. We'll see you at next week.
Yeah, I'll see you in like 6 days.
That summit you guys put together, I'm sure you've been hearing about this. The buzz is it's like nothing else before. We hope that's going to happen again, because that's just put the fuel in the tanks for, you know, so many people. Unreal.
That's awesome. I just love hearing that. That's so
good. Big time. So
yeah.
Thank you so much.
You bet. And Caleb, so you're going to be at New York Kickoff?
Yep.
Okay, great. Well, let me know, Josh, if you just want to text me sometime during the event. I'd love to meet up with Caleb and, you know, just chat some more.
Awesome. Cool. We'll do.
Looking forward to it.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Guys. All right.
Take care. Clebby, I'll call you in a minute.
Oh, all right.
Cool. There you are. Stay on.
I'm right here.